It is like Blinkist is reading my mind because day 1, day 2, 3, day 4, day of the 5-day Blinkist challenge. Hi everyone, welcome to a new video. This is Nishma from the Millennial Lifestyle Fix. In today's video, I'm going to talk about Blinkist, which is an app that gives you short summaries of books. And I've been using it for quite some time now and loving it. In fact, I also participated in the Blinkist challenge. If you want to know more about this app and what this challenge is, what are some of the good things which I like about this app, then please keep on watching. For this video, I'm going to share with you 5 blinks which I'm going to read throughout this week, Monday to Friday, and I'm going to share how I like each blink and what are some of the reasons why I like the app itself, Blinkist, and whether you guys should try it or not based on my experience. So every day we will listen to one blink, which is around 15 to 20 minutes of a short summary of a book. So based on that, we can decide whether we want to read that book or not. Another great thing is that since we don't have a lot of time, these short summaries or blinks are a great way to keep on learning, and it is the perfect amount of time through which we can easily, quickly learn something very useful. I've been listening to blinks for about past 1.5 years, and I want to get in the routine of making it a daily habit. That is why I'm taking this challenge. So let's get on and get started with this video and go to day 1 of this Blinkist challenge. Hi guys, today is day 1 of the 5-day Blinkist challenge, and today's blink is called The Science of Living. So I'm just going to go and listen to it and come back quickly and tell you guys how I liked it. It's a quick 20-minute blink, and I'm really excited because it's based on productivity, motivation and all those things which I love. So I'm going to listen to the blink, come back and tell you guys how I liked it. Let's go. So I'm back from listening to the blink, and it was really good. It was how you should like go about your day and life based on science. So everything from waking up in the morning to, you know, like what is the time when you would be most productive according to science, whether you should socialize or not, everything, and going right to into your nighttime routine, what are the rituals or like, you know, some of the things that you should have set up so that your next day is great. It was really good read and like motivating and putting things into perspective. So I definitely recommend it. I'm gonna put a photo over here of the blink itself, and now let's go to day 2 and see what blink is waiting for us next. Today is day 2 of the 5-day Blinkist challenge, and today's book is known as the Pegan Diet. So this is a mix of paleo and vegan diet, and I personally am a vegetarian who eats eggs, so eggetarian. So I'm really interested to know what this vegan and paleo vegan diet is all about. It's a 23 minutes book. Before I talk about today's book, I quickly want to talk about the book I read yesterday, which was about vegan diet, which is vegan and paleo diet. So I told you I'm going to come back and update you, but I forgot about updating you guys. So it was a really great read, and I obviously do know what vegan diet is now, but I think the way they explain it about how your plate of food should have rainbow colors, what does it mean, and that fats are not bad, you should try to include them in forms of seeds and nuts, and have carbohydrates in form of complex carbs, all of that was really like insightful. So I enjoyed that book as well. And now let's go and talk about Set Boundaries, Find Peace, which is today's blink for day 3. We have reached day 3 of the 5-day Blinkist challenge, and today's book is called Set Boundaries, Find Peace. It is like Blinkist is reading my mind because this whole week I was thinking about setting boundaries and how to go about it. And yes, we do need boundaries, whether it is in our personal relationships or professional relationships. So let's go ahead and listen to this blink. I'm going to put a picture of it right here, and I'm going to come back and tell you how I like it. Back from listening to the blink, and it was really, really great. It's like reinforcing the things that you already know about setting boundaries. So it took us through a lot of different boundaries. There's sexual boundaries, work boundaries, in personal life, time related boundaries, and you know, having boundaries with your parents, your partner, everything was covered. And it was really like informative about how to actually go about setting these boundaries without offending someone. And if someone has set boundaries for you, you should also not be offended, because that is something that they would really need to do. So I think setting boundaries is really important, and sometimes we, like, you know, keep it on a back seat, but it is really important for self-care, because if we do not set boundaries, we end up getting burnt and then blaming others for it. So in order to break this cycle, it is great to set boundaries, and I'm sure that you guys might also be facing some of similar situations. So this blink on set boundaries, find peace, is something I really recommend. Now let's go on to day four. Today is day four of my 5-day Blinkist challenge, and today's blink was called as Abundance. It was a book about how there are, like, so many things which are happening good and which will happen better in the future. So all the time we think that because of the pandemic and everything that, you know, the future is going to be doomed. There's globalization, bad politics and governments, all these things. But at the same time, there are a lot of good things happening, like the spread of information and technology, globalization, biotechnology, robotics. So there were all these examples that how are these things going to make the future better. So we are really living in the golden age where, you know, there is no war. Like, there are wars, but it's not as bad as how it was before. So it was really an optimistic look on the future, and I really enjoyed that. One thing which I came to know from this blink, which I learned today, which I did not know before, is that, did you know there is something called as the Best Failure Idea Award? So this award has been started by Ratan Tata from Tata Industries, and what this award is for is to promote the idea of innovation and experimentation. So normally whenever we want to try something new, we're always scared that we will fail, but this award is every year that company Tata will select one idea which was started or innovated but failed, and what are the things to learn from them, because even failure is a great way of learning from something. So you should not be afraid from experimenting, and this is why I love blinks, because just in a quick 20 minute walk, I listen to a blink and I learn something new. So let's see what is going to be the next blink, which is going to be blink for... We've made it to the fifth day of the 5-day Blinkist challenge, and today's blink is Steve Jobs. I'm gonna put a picture right here. So I'm really excited to listen to this blink in particular. So let me quickly go listen to it and come back. So I'm back. It was a great blink. Anyone who is interested in Steve Jobs, the company Apple itself, or technology, I think there's a lot to learn from his life. So starting off, how he, you know, initially had the idea, how he worked with his partner, and then, you know, how he's so, like, particular about Apple design, and why, you know, that would take them such a long time to design things in the beginning, but now that is actually the USP of the brand itself. So it's really great to know, like, some of how his life was actually and what made him what he is right now. So I really enjoyed this blink as well, and overall I would say all the blinks throughout this 5-day challenge were really great, and I got to learn a lot. So I look forward to listening to... I love using Blinkist is because it removes the decision fatigue of what should I read, right? You already have a recommendation for each day, and you will have one blink which is free for that day, so you can just go ahead and read it or listen to it. You don't have to decide what to read, and it will just help you to learn something every single day in a very short summary and informative form, so that your learning journey is also always on the go and continuing. So I like it that I don't need to think about what to read, and I can just go and listen to whatever is recommended to me for that day. Sometimes this becomes a challenge, because I remember a few days ago I was thinking about listening to a blink for that day, and it was something related to do with criminal psychology and something like that, but I was not in a mood to listen to that. So on that day, I just skipped it. So for some days like that, when you don't actually want to read the blink that is recommended to you, but I think these cases will be really rare, you can just go ahead and read the whole book which you are, like, listening to on the other side, like any book of your choice or whatever other reading that you want to do. But I think for a daily reading and learning process, Blinkist is a great app, and I definitely recommend it to you guys. So do try it out and leave your thoughts in the comments. Did you find this video useful? And please be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel, The Millennial Lifestyle Fix, for more such videos. And make sure to hit the notification button, so every time I upload a video, you will get notified. Until next video, this is bye-bye from me, Nishma, from The Millennial Lifestyle Fix. Bye-bye and take care.